right-hand side as Peter. And I thought, this is a change in our relationship with God. We don't have the old relationship with God, which is to do with obedience, fear and punishment. We have a new relationship, which is to do with love and forgiveness through Jesus Christ. We have our opening prayer. Lord of all, as we gather here to worship you, we ask you for hearts open to your presence. Fill this church with your spirit and our souls with your peace. Let every song, prayer and word spoken glorify you and draw us closer in communion with you and with each other. Amen. Now we're going to sing Friend of God, and this is our children's song at the beginning of the service. So I'm hoping that some children will come and help with the actions. I know Tori will, she's getting up. So do come up onto the steps here and help us with the actions. Join in with the actions and sing as heartily as you can.
True that you
standing as we say together the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. This is a slot where we reflect back on the week, where we think about that which we pray for and that which has affected us this week, how God has been at work in our lives this week. And I'm just wondering if anyone has got anything that they would like to share with us of this week. Katina.
Hi, it's about that word courage. Now, we had that word last weekend, but for me, I had that word for my daughter who's going through some stuff. Be strong, be courageous, for the Lord your God is with you. And it's, I think the emphasis of that is the Lord your God is with you. He is with you wherever you are, whatever you're doing, and whatever you may be suffering. He is with you in your pain. He is with you in your joy. He is with you. He won't leave you. And that's what I'm getting from this. So we can have courage because God is with us. He's within. He will not leave you desolate. And this is what I told my daughter, and she was greatly encouraged because it's been three times in my family, and particularly for my daughter. But he is with you. I think that, you know, it's an amazing thing. We've just talked about being a friend, and he is our friend. He does love us, and he doesn't want to leave us desolate. So have faith, have courage. He is with you.
That's amazing. Katina and Tony tell many stories of courage. He is for us. Carol's coming up to share.
Definitely think this word courage is going on. So first of all, I'd like to thank you all that do know that and have been praying for me, because I had the courage to step out and listen to my calling. And I'd just like to say that I've managed to get onto the Caleb stream and I'm going for ordination. So the bishop, he said, yes. So thank you very much. And it's going to take a lot of courage to continue to work. So
fabulous examples of God at work. Are you coming up, Ezra, too? I know you've got a story to tell.
So we were doing our prayers for 5 minutes, and I came up with a sense of a hole. So it started off with a small hole, but then we dug deeper, and it began to get bigger. And I said that we should do that with our faith, because we should dig deeper into our faith.
Words of wise, words of wisdom from small, faith-filled people. That's wonderful. Anyone else want to share? Well, that's plenty to make us smile and encourage us, I think. So we have next a song, I think. And I think it's Great Is Our Faithfulness. So if you'd like to stand, then we'll sing Great Is Thy Faithfulness, which absolutely matches what we've heard this morning.
Thank you. Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not thy compassions, they fail not. As thou hast been, thou forever will be. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see.
For the reading. I think our message this morning is that we should have courage and joy and belief in that faithfulness that God has for us. Carol is reading to us this morning and then going straight into the reflection. So if you would just close your eyes and pray, join in the prayer this morning. Heavenly Father, who speaks to us through word and spirit, open our ears to hear what you would say to us and open our hearts to follow your path. Amen.
Psalm 84. How lovely is your dwelling place, Lord Almighty. My soul yearns, even faints, for the courts of the Lord. My heart and my flesh cry out for the living God. Even the sparrow has found a home, and the swallow a nest for herself, where she may have her young, a place near your altar. Lord Almighty, my King and my God, blessed are those who dwell in your house. They are ever praising you. Blessed are those whose strength is in you, whose hearts are set on pilgrimage as they pass through the valley of Baca. They make it a place of springs. The autumn rains also cover it with pools. They go from strength to strength, till each appears before God in Zion. Hear my prayer, Lord God Almighty. Listen to me, God of Jacob. Look on our shield, O God. Look with favour on your anointed one. Better is one day in your courts than a thousand elsewhere. I would rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God than dwell in the tents of the wicked. For the Lord God is a sun and a shield. The Lord bestows favor and honor. No good thing does he withhold from those whose walk is blameless. Lord Almighty, blessed is the one who trusts in you. When Pippa asked me to choose a psalm to speak on, I was a little bit thrown, actually, because in my younger days, I would have been sitting here in the choir and singing many psalms on a Sunday evening. And there are so many psalms that I really enjoy. But I was very drawn to Psalm 84. A song I can really relate to. I have a friend who's made a really costly decision. Tanya would love to be married. Her heart, her whole self aches for somebody. She wants to love and be loved. Set up a home, eventually have a baby. And along he comes, this guy, interesting and funny and comfortable. She loves being with him and in his company. She wants him. He's told her that he wants her. Their mutual friends watch on. To them, it's perfect. But I'm nervous. She's a Christian. He's not. I wonder what she'll do. Tanya says no. To most of her friends, it makes no sense at all. She's upset, saying no is clearly a wrench for her. So why is she doing it? Tanya says no because she knows that to be with this guy would put her relationship with Jesus in jeopardy. Her friends don't get it, but I find it inspiring. I know how much she wanted this guy and the life she could have had with him. But now I know, I have evidence that she wants Jesus more. She weighed it up and Jesus won. She wants Jesus more than she wants a husband. When I read Psalm 84, I'm reminded of people like Tanya and myself over the last few years. Psalm 84 is a psalm of passionate love. love for God, the kind of love for God that drives people to make costly sacrifices. The psalmist beautifully expresses his longing to be with God. His longing is so intense, so passionate, that a love song is the only way he can tell it. The psalmist is on his way up to the temple in Jerusalem, to God's house, a place he can meet with God. Listen to what he says. How lovely is your dwelling place, O Lord of hosts. The word lovely here doesn't mean nice or pretty or pleasant. It's much stronger than that. The lovely here has connotations of a romantic love. The pull he feels towards God's temple is as strong as love. How lovely is your dwelling place, O Lord of hosts. My soul longs, yes, faints for the courts of the Lord. My heart and flesh sing for joy to the living God. This is an almost physical longing he feels. His whole self, his heart and flesh and soul, they're pulled to God. He sings, he faints. It's joy and pain together. Maybe you've experienced that kind of attraction for someone. You'll know what the psalmist feels. He so longs to go to the temple and meet with his Lord. He must get there. A chord in his heart is connecting him to God. In verse 3, he envies the birds because they get to build their nests in the temple, lay their eggs there, be there all the time. Even the sparrow finds a home and the swallow a nest for herself, where she may lay her young at your altars. O Lord of hosts, my King and my God, blessed are those who dwell in your house, ever singing your praise. The birds are happy. They live in the temple, always singing God's praise. Oh, that the psalmist could do the same thing. He goes on, blessed are those who dwell in your house, ever singing your praise. Blessed are those whose strength is in you, in whose heart are the highways to Zion. His heart is like a highway to Zion. His every thought is headed there. He's like a lover, always thinking of his beloved. And he says that it's right that he feels this pull. God's temple is where blessing lies. As they go through the valley of Baca, the desert valley, they make it a place of springs. They go from strength to strength. Each one appears before God in Zion. The psalmist has no doubt that those who are drawn to Zion will arrive. Those who long for God will find him. They will stand before him, and it will be everything they hope for. For a day in your courts is better than 1,000 elsewhere. I would rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God. For the Lord God is sun and shield. The Lord bestows favour and honour. No good thing does he withhold. All of the psalmist's longing will be rewarded. There will be no disappointment. Just one day at the destination would have made the whole journey worthwhile. To get to be there as a street sweeper would be better than being king anywhere else. O Lord of hosts, blessed is the one who trusts in you. Blessed is the one whose heart is pulled towards Zion, who longs for God. Unlike the psalmist, we have no earthly temple to travel to. It's not the city of Jerusalem in the Middle East that we're drawn to. our longing is for God himself, for Jesus, for the new Jerusalem he's making for us, where we will be with him, know him, stand in his courts. Do you feel the pull? Is your heart longing, thirsting to be with God? My friend Tanya would say that hers isn't. She would say that she doesn't feel the psalmist's passion for God. She would describe her love as weak and wavering. But I think her actions tell the real story. Her love for God is stronger than her desire for marriage, stronger than her desire to have earthly company and physical love. Her actions show that her heart is drawn to Jesus, tied to him. Eventually, her feelings will catch up. I think reading a psalm like this is a good way to help you, your feelings catch up. The sacrifices that Tanya makes in this life for God will be repaid in eternity, over and over again. When she gets to heaven, she'll laugh. She'll say that it was all so worth it. She'll say that she'd do it 100 times over. One day with God is worth 1,000 anywhere else. Sacrifice? What sacrifice? I think it took her a lot of courage, didn't you? I think that word courage is really coming through to us all today. Psalm 84. I can really relate to. Can you?
Thank you, Carol, for those words to us, and to help us reflect upon them, there's a song now called Better One Day in your courts. I don't know it, some of you may, but please do join in as you can and as you learn it, or just sit quietly and reflect upon the words.
Better is one day in your course.
Father, we thank you for St. Michael's and pray that you would bless us here. We pray for Pippa in her walk with you and in leading our church. Also for Emily Grace in her training. And thank you, Lord, that Carol has been accepted for the Caleb stage of training and evaluation. Bless her in this, we pray. And we pray for Tori and her work amongst the young people here. We pray for all who carry out roles that allow the church to function and for unity of spirit and purpose in all that is attempted to the glory of God. We pray for the sick and those who are bereaved amongst us. We particularly think of Elaine, family and friends, and we bring them before you and we pause for a few moments as we hold them and others that are known to us in silent prayer. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Father, we thank you that we can worship freely and meet together within our nation in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray for our brothers and sisters around the world who are severely persecuted for their faith. We bring before you the top 10 countries where the level of persecution is extreme, according to the Open Doors charity. We pray for the Christians in North Korea, Somalia, Libya, Eritrea, Yemen, Nigeria, Pakistan, Sudan, Iran, and Afghanistan. We also pray for the believers in the remaining 40 nations that time restricts us to name, but also suffer very high levels of persecution. Hold them close to you in your loving embrace and deliver them from those who would harm them. As they go through the valley of Baca, let them drink the water from the springs of your loving heart. Grant them justice for your name's sake. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Father, we pray for those nations faced with war, including Ukraine, which is fighting to hold on to its independence established in 1991 and commemorated yesterday, 24th of August. We pray for all the other troubled areas of the world, the Middle East especially now, as tensions are rising between Hezbollah and Israel as we speak. We pray for the international armed conflicts between India and Pakistan, between India and China, and the non-international armed conflicts, like civil war or groups fighting one another. We pray for them. We pray for Myanmar, Afghanistan, the Philippines, Latin America, the African continent, and the Balkans, where tensions are high. There are more than we can bring before you now, but we pray for greater world stability and for wisdom to be granted to all people who pursue peace. Lord, in your mercy, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
We'll pray together the prayer that Jesus gave us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Now we come to our time of notices. Because Pippa's not here this week, we are not having a communion, and so we have a slightly shorter morning service this morning, not a communion, but now is our notices. Every Thursday, between 10 and 11:30, we have a toddler group here with youngsters and their parents and carers, maybe childminders, meeting in the hall that Tori leads and prepares for. And another member of the congregation helps with tea and coffee. Do pass that along to anyone that you know that might be interested in coming to that group. I guess during the holidays, Tori, there are some older children that are coming as well. And if you can help at all with tea and coffee for that group, on the odd occasion, there is a sign-up sheet at the back. But the most important thing is to take a flyer and give it to someone that you know with small children who might be interested. The weekend, I think it's the 8th of September, the Saturday and Sunday, the 8th of September, there is an open day to celebrate the heritage of this beautiful building, the oldest church in Camberley. That will be between 2 and 4. I think there's an open tower where you can go and see the bells and have a go at ringing them, and there will be people here and information about the building. Again, do take a flyer and pass it on to anyone who's interested. And if you can be here that afternoon, even for half an hour, to welcome people in, then do. Very excitingly, on the 15th of September, the following Sunday, we have two amazing musicians coming to play to us, an organist and a trumpet player, and they are of very, very high standing and friends of Patricia Kawar, who is organising this concert. It's just for an hour, between 4 and 5. All the tickets are £10, and they're all in aid of St Michael's. Patricia's kindly sponsoring the musicians. There will be refreshments as well. So do pass this message on, buy tickets, and come along to what promises to be an amazing concert. On the end of September, we have our pet show, and there will be lots to do, lots to participate in. Again, do take a flyer, pass it along to anyone who might like to come along. I don't think you even need to like animals particularly. There's lots of things to do and lots of people to talk to and a great deal of fun. I think that's between 11 in the morning and 3 in the afternoon. And as usual, just before we get to tea and coffee, Alison has asked me to let you know that there is a revised list for Ukraine. Alison and David have been very active in raising equipment to go and help both in the hospitals and emergency ambulances in Ukraine, and in to relieve the plight of the civilians suffering there. And I know that they, the kind of aim of their collection has slightly changed, so please do take an updated list at the back. And there, as usual, is tea and coffee in the hall and a chance to chat with each other. So do come and join us with that, everybody. And now our final song is My Lighthouse. I know this song is well known for some of the children. I'm hoping once again you might come up and join me at the front because there's lots of actions. Thank you, Ezra. Just wait a minute while they're getting ready. Show us how the actions go. How do you go when you say, you're my light?
Wrestling in my doubts, in my failures, you won't walk out. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Whoa, you are the peace in my troubled sea. In the silence, you won't let go. Questions your truth will hold. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Whoa, you are the peace in my troubled sea. My lighthouse, my lighthouse, shining in the darkness, I will follow you. To show.
and sing. Yeah, I say today, tomorrow.
Well, they're all different, you know. So from YouTube, well, potentially they're different volumes. So the last one I did bring down a bit, but yeah. I moved back half of the screen. And one of the others I put up a bit.
Yeah.
Did you want to talk about music at PCC?
Oh, yeah.
So,
that's great to say.
Send it to me.
Yeah.
That'd be brilliant.
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
I'll then need to let Pippa know.
Yeah, that's fine. Oh, that's fine. That's okay.
Yeah.
No, I keep meaning. Well, I was going to talk to her about it after that last time, but I thought no. If we can, I just want to get other people. What other people think about it as well. You know, I'm sure it's not just me.
Oh, is it? Well, it is.
And we need to be able to discuss it to try and get what we want.
There is this quiet dichotomy for you, because you know, she and others will think, well, you've got to liven it up, or
yeah.
make it practical.
But something, we should be able to still have something.
Some traditional, nice versions,
yeah. Yeah, but I'll send it to
that Faithfulness song, I couldn't see it.
No, it's hard.
So slow.
It's hard, not a good version.
Why can't we just have a hymn version?
Yeah. There's some really nice ones.
There must be.
When I was looking for Corinne Lodge, I used to find some really nice ones, you know, more traditional. But I know she does. That's the big problem. She doesn't like the traditional version. So you end up with...
Well, a guitar, solo guitar, the part that changes notes. And the blokes in the
middle.
That's
really neat, though, isn't it?
Well, it's all right. Yeah. I think as we get used to it.
Does it slide up and down?
Yeah.
Who meant to you make
David, no, David.
DP.
Yeah.
And you stayed it like that. Would it be possible, because then you could take more of an interaction with whoever's on panel, you could take more of an interaction, if you got one of those clip-on stand things, that like a swivel thing that they have in offices for monitors, and you have a face, so you could...
More this way.
Yeah, so because otherwise you're sort of looking there because you want to see what the next slide is. You're missing the signals from the vicar or whoever's leaving to say next slide please, because you're looking down. It's like, oh, I missed that one.
Yeah.
But if it was sort of,
we could put it in.
Yeah. But you'd have one of those sort of like an angle poised lamp type thing with a laptop stand. And it would just there. And it wouldn't be bad because you could push it back there.
Yeah.
Just a question.
Yes, it is. Ones where you can just about see the top of the stone and the rest of it's like there's one up on the Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 3, 2, 4.
Is required now for the without the mic.
Right, that's right.
Yeah.
Cool.
Testing 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Testing 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. value for the collection is on the desk, is the money in the safe?
Not yet. I'm about to put it in.
Okay.
Have you signed it?
I haven't. Well, sorry, I thought it was away. I couldn't see it. Or didn't see it. Pardon?
Oh.
contacted Railfreight and they said,